Hi, this is Brad with Copper Creek Cuts, a lawn care company in Northeast Florida. And the video that you're seeing in the background is one that I actually uploaded. Let's see. Oh gosh, it's almost been a year. That's very depressing. I was supposed to film a second part to this. This is an overview of the Volt landscape lighting kit that you get from Costco. And this was supposed to be part one of a series. Part two is the actual installation. Now, while I filmed all these around the same time, the winter of 2018, I never actually made the second video. It sat on my editor on my older computer for quite some time until finally I felt guilty enough because of how many people were asking in the comments of this video, where's part two? Where's part two? When's part two gonna come out? So lo and behold, we're going to get into part two right now. But just as a refresher, this is kind of part two of a series. This first part that you're watching now and is linked in the top right is an overview of this landscape lighting kit. Now, when we look at the actual installation, of course, these steps here will vary depending on what type of lights you get, what brand, but for the Volt kit, you're gonna wanna go ahead and unscrew this top, put your LED bulbs in, screw the top back on. The very tip will come off so that your hat can slide in here. And you'll go ahead and make sure that that little felt washer is there to secure the hat as well. This stake is what holds it into the ground. You get a couple of extra set screws and an Allen key. That's going to be important because this Allen key is what holds the light fixture to the brown plastic stake base. So make sure you go ahead and smash it in good with your foot there to get it anchored. And then once the light fixture is bottomed out in that plastic stake, you'll go ahead and tighten down your set screw so that it's not going to go anywhere, and then just pile your mulch back over it to hide the base. This installation was a little tricky. The gentleman wanted the control center inside his garage, so I had to go get this huge drill bit and actually make the hole where the irrigation line came out of the garage, had to make it a little bit bigger for all the wiring. So use the existing line for the irrigation system and just had to make the hole bigger. It took quite a while with a hammer drill, but finally you see we've got a hole big enough to accommodate all the wiring. If you don't need the control center inside, it's a little bit easier. You'll just find a good spot for it outside close to a power outlet. Then you'll go ahead and position the rest of your lights. You'll see me pushing down on the lights to stake them in the ground. Don't do that. Put the plastic stake in first, smash that down with your foot, and then gently put the lights in. Don't press down on the lights to install them. That's not a good practice. If you're installing in a landscape bed, you'll go ahead and move the mulch aside. If you're installing on turf, then you'll need to dig a trench. You'll see in a second the tool that I like to use for this. Another thing to mention too, if you're crossing under a sidewalk, there are special drill bits that you can get for that. The gentleman at this property actually planned for this whenever he built this house. This is a new construction. So he actually had installed some PVC conduit with, I don't know if they're called runners or fishing lines, but basically it was very easy for me to get the wiring underneath the sidewalk because the homeowner here had already taken care of it. If that's not the case with you, like I said, there's a special drill bit you can get that lets you drill through the dirt and then hook the wire. This is a really good tool. Basically, just slam it down and wiggle it back and forth and it makes a little trench, which is a lot easier and a lot less effort than actually having to dig with a shovel. So I really, really like this tool. There is a little bit of a learning curve. I definitely recommend slamming it down a few times to get it deeper and pushing it back and forth to get a wider trench. There were quite a few spots in this job where it was a little bit narrower than it should have been, and it was kind of difficult to install the line. And once that trench is dug, you'll go ahead and just run all your wire. This was probably the most tedious part of the job because you've got to go through every single inch and tamp those wires down. Not the best or easiest thing in the world. Here I'm using some leftover piece of fencing that I found on the property. If you could get something that was a little narrower, maybe I don't know, like a dowel or something, or just a thinner piece of wood, it would work a lot better. But this is the next step, is tamping those wires down to the bottom of that trench. With this Volt kit, they install these lighting hubs. So basically your landscape lighting consists of a light with two wires. One of those wires is going into one side of the hub, the other wire is going into the other side of the hub. When they're all connected, then you just have one wire running from the hub to the control box, rather than, you know, 8 wires or 10 wires or however many lights you have. Once all that wiring is run and in the trench, you'll go ahead and cover up the very small trench, which is going to be pretty easy because, again, it's small, and then you can rake your mulch back into place. Once that's done throughout the whole property, then you'll go to wherever you're installing your box. Again, in this case, it was in the garage. Then you'll hook up the lighting from the hubs to the box, one to the common, one to the 15 volt, pretty simple. And a little cable management. Probably would have been better if I had black zip ties, but unfortunately white was all I had on the truck. And there you have it. The landscape lighting is in, it's done. It's a fairly straightforward procedure. If you've got any questions, please let me know down in the comments below. I respond to comments almost every other day, no matter how old a video is. If you'd like to see some more landscape lighting videos, here's a few that YouTube thinks you might like. But in any case, thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it.